In today's video, I'm going to show you chemistry data basics in the KNIME Analytics Platform. First of all, let's have a look at the different data types. Each column in the KNIME table has a data type. The standard types which are commonly used are string, double, and integer. Dedicated cheminformatics extensions like the KNIME Base Chemistry extension, but also other commercial and community extensions from the cheminformatics field will allow to deal with chemistry data types, like SDF, MOL, MOL2, and SMILES, for example. They facilitate rendering as well as conversions of these data types. So let's have a look at the example workflow. KNIME provides various nodes to read in chemistry data. Starting with the file reader, which is a native KNIME node, it is possible to read in different file types, such as text or CSV files. The file reader guesses its settings by analyzing the file content. By default, columns of type SMILES are recognized as strings, but the column properties can be easily changed by clicking on the column header and selecting the type SMILES. The SDF reader reads an SDF file and creates several columns with each molecule in a new row. SDF stands for Structure Data File, in which multiple compounds are delimited by lines consisting of four dollar signs. It can also include associated data items, which are declared within angle brackets. You can set the node to read these data items by selecting to extract different types of blocks. In the configuration of the node, you can select several input sources, including URLs. If you want to extract the whole molecule, for example, you can choose Extract SDF blocks. By selecting Extract mole blocks, only the mole blocks without properties are extracted. Furthermore, if you are interested in the molecule's atom and bond counts, you can also select Extract Counts. Last but not least, I want to show you the mole file reader, which reads in mole files from a directory and creates a row for each file. The KNIME Base Chemistry extension also provides a mole2 reader. If you have chemistry data in a KNIME table, but it's in cells of the wrong type, you can fix this using the Molecule Typecast node. It can change the assigned data type of a column from string to other chemistry types, such as mole2, SMILES, or SMARTS. Note that this doesn't modify the data in the cell or do any chemistry translation. The RDKit Canon SMILES node generates canonical SMILES for an input mole column. Canonical SMILES gives a single canonical form for any particular molecule. You may want to use this node if you have different SMILES for the same molecule and bring that into a uniform format. After we have brought our various inputs into a uniform format, we can now work with the tables. Concatenating appends the rows of one table to another. Various joining will combine tables where a specific key value matches. To make sure that we don't have duplicate rows, we use the duplicate row filter. Using the column filter afterwards provides us the opportunity to exclude all the columns with incomplete data or only include columns of our interest. If you have installed any cheminformatics extension containing a renderer, you can use the renderer to image node, select the molecule column and the according renderer. With the resulting images, you can easily create an interactive view. Similar to the chemistry reader nodes, the chemistry base extension provides multiple writer nodes, like the mole file, mole2, or SDF writer node. But in case you would like to write the SMILES to an Excel file, you can also use the Excel writer node.